3 and 6, 54, 7. Okay, thank you. So first we will see where we stop in our last class. So this is where we have stopped to check our plan's finish date in the timeline. So we saw the finish date of our project in the timeline view. And then we also did this thing to check a plan's duration, finish date, and more in the statistics dialog box. So that part also we did in our last class. So we will move on to the next part. So next part is to display the project summary tasks. So then we will see how to display the project summary tasks in our project user interface. So it is here. Before beginning our session, I have to tell you another one thing I forgot to tell you. In our last class, here you can see, while I continue our last session, I told you that in every project, the Saturdays and Sundays are considered as non-working days. But here, in this project, you can see in this activity, view suitable sites. Here, they have considered a Sunday as the finish day of this view suitable sites activity. The reason for this is because here the duration is for E-days, for entire days. That is why they have considered a weekend also. So the start days is a Wednesday. But I think, I don't know whether you remember, in our last class, I told you that the Wednesday we are going to consider as recurring non-working days because our project manager is going to visit the project site on Wednesday. So Wednesday, we are going to be nominated as a recurring non-working day. So even though the project displayed Wednesday as the starting day, here it does not consider as these entire days. So here the project considers Thursday, Friday, Saturday and Sunday. Those continuous 4 days they are going to consider as 4 entire days. So throughout these entire days, the project team has to work from morning to night without getting any break. So sometimes we may be able to think that the people can consider Thursday, Friday and skip weekend and start from Monday and Tuesday. But that is not going to be possible because entire days means we have to consider a continuous process. So even though we usually consider Saturday and Sunday as non-working days, because of the entire days concept, we have to consider here this Saturday and Sunday also as work days, only for this view suitable sites activity. So I forgot to tell you that in the last class. So with that reminder, now we will see how to display the project summary task. So in order to display the project summary task, here in the format tab, here you can see a checkbox called project summary task. So you have to click on that. So when we click on that, this shows the name of that project. Here, I will enlarge this one. So this is the name of our project, building construction project. So that is the name we gave to this project. So they have displayed it here. And they have already given us the duration, 54 days. So that is the entire duration of our project. So that is the total of these summary tasks. And the start date of the project is 14th of June. And finish date is 3rd of September. And also, here you can see an icon. So when we put our cursor on that icon, they show a note. This is our first project. So I think you must be able to remember that in our first day, we have entered the details of our project here. Here, under building construction project properties dialog box, under comments, we have typed, this is our first project. So that comment is displayed here as a note. This is our first project. So that is what is indicated here. So this is how we can display the project summary task. So then we will move on to the next part. So after displaying the summary task, next we have to document task information. So here, in order to document task information, we are going to add some notes and hyperlinks to our project plan. So we will see how to do that one. So this is our project plan. So here we will see how to enter a note first. So I am going to enter a note to this first activity, define requirements. So by giving notes to various activities, we can describe some specific things about that particular activity. So that is why we use notes. So when any other external person comes to check our project plan, if he want to know ideas of any particular activity, so by putting his cursor on the note icon, then he can get all the information about that activity. So for that purpose, we are using notes. So we will see how to give a note for an activity. So I am going to give a note for defined requirements. So in order to do that, we can double click on this one. And then we can get this dialog box, task information. And here you can see a tab called notes. So click on that one. And here you can type anything. So we are going to identify all the requirements of this project. Requirements of the project like this, and then you can click OK. So now here, this is the note icon. So when we put our cursor here we can see the note. Here we are going to identify all the requirements of the project. So that is how we can enter a note. And the other thing is hyperlink. So sometimes we can enter hyperlinks also for some activities. So by using the hyperlink, we can enter some websites. That means we should have already prepared some website for our project. And then that means for some activities, we can create some specific websites. And then by creating a specific icon, specific link, in order to go to that web address, we can give a hyperlink. So we will see how to do that one. For example, I will give a hyperlink for set budget activity. So to do that, we have to right click on that one. And then there is an option called hyperlink. So you have to click on that one. And then we can get this dialog box, insert hyperlink. And then here you can see text to display. So here we can type anything. So when we type anything here, so after we put our cursor here, that text will be automatically displayed. So here I will type like this. All the budget details are here. All the budget details are here. And then this is the address. Here we can type the web address. So currently we do not have any web address, but here in order to show you, I am going to assume a fake web address. So I will type a fake web address. It really doesn't exist. I will give a name like budget details. Yes, budget detail. This name is good. I have already prepared one. budgetdetails.vau.jfn.ac.lk. So I will give this name. This really does not exist in the real world. Just I form a web address in order to show you. So click OK. So then here you can see the hyperlink icon. So when we put our cursor here, you can see the text. All the budget details are here. So if that website really exists, when you click on that one, you can go to that website and get all the budget details. So that is the facility of the hyperlink. So that is how we can enter notes and hyperlink to our project plan. So I hope you are clear with that one. So we will go to next part. So after doing that one, so next we have to do is to quickly remove notes, hyperlinks or formatting from the selected task. So next we will see how to remove these things, notes and hyperlinks. So here, suddenly we decide we do not need this note and hyperlink any longer. So if we decide to remove these things, what we have to do is we can just click on this note, and in the tasks tab, here you can see a button called clear, and you have to click on this arrow next to the clear word. And then here you can see the notes option. So you can click on that one. And then here you can see the note icon is disappeared. So if you want to remove this hyperlink, you can click on this one and go to clear, and then here clear hyperlinks, click on that one. So like that you can remove the hyperlink also if it is not necessary for you. So that is how we can remove those things. So we will go to the next part then. So I think that is all. Yes, that is all in the first chapter, fourth chapter. So do you have any question up to now from the chapter 4? If you have any question, you can ask. Okay, apparently you do not have any question, then I will move on. So next I am going to do the practice task in that PDF book, MS Project Step by Step. So we will see what we have to do there. So this is the practice task for chapter 4. So the simple build task list practice file for this task is located in the Project 2016 BS chapter 4 folder. So first of all, we have to get that practice file here. So I will close the building construction project one. So this one I'm going to close now. And I will get the practical file. So in this practical file, we have to go to chapter 4 and then get this simple build task list. Okay. So this is the simple build task list plan. So we have to do all the activities here now according to that PDF book. So we will see first of all what we have to do. So here, create task, the scenario. You are a project manager at Lucerne Publishing. You have collected the initial task names for a new book launch and are ready to start. Open the Simple Build task list plan in project and perform the following tasks. So now we are going to work on a new project. That project name is a book launch project, and we are going to work as a project manager. So now, first of all, we have to enter these tasks. So first, we will enter these tasks to our project. First one is assign launch team members. So here I will type assign launch team members. And the second activity is design and order marketing material. And third one, distribute advanced copies. Here, design and order marketing material. Materials, and third one is distribute advanced copies. And what is the next activity? So next, coordinate magazine feature articles and launch public web portal for book. So here, coordinate magazine feature articles and launch public web portal for book. Launch public web portal for book. So these are the activities we had to enter. So next we will see what we have to do. So after that, while reviewing the task you entered, you realize that you missed a task. You will insert that task next. So among these activities, we have missed one activity. So next we are going to enter that one. Insert a new task name. Public launch phase, so that it will appear above the distribute advanced copies. So we have to enter this new activity. Public launch phase it should be above distribute advanced copies. So here, this is the distribute advanced copies, and above this we have to enter the new task. So I will right click and click on insert task, and here we can type public launch phase. Public launch phase. Okay. And after that, enter task duration and dates. Scenario: you showed your initial task list to the resources who will perform the work and add to other project stakeholders. They gave you their preliminary, although incomplete, feedback on some task durations and dates, which you would like to record in the new book launch plan. Continuing in the Simple Build task list plan, perform the following tasks. So now after entering our activities, next we have to enter the duration of those activities. So first one is enter a duration of 1 day for task one, assign launch team members. So we will do that one. So So this one, assign launch team members as 1 day. So that means 1 and D. And then so here, enter the following durations or text phrases for the other tasks. Design and order marketing material, check with marketing team. Then public launch phase, leave blank, so we don't need to enter any duration here. And distribute advanced copies 2 days. So for these 3 tasks, we will enter this duration. Check with marketing team, leave blank, and 2 days. So this one, check with marketing team. We can just type it. Check with marketing team. So I will enlarge this one. And public launch phase leave blank and distribute advanced copies 2 days. And then so next part, for task 5, coordinate magazine feature articles in the start field, enter 22nd of January 2018, and in the finish field, enter 30th of January 2018. So we will enter these start dates and finish dates for task 5, coordinate magazine feature articles. So this one, start day is 22nd of January in 2018. So we have to go to 2018 January, here 22nd, and finish day is 30th of January. So we have to go to 2018. So here 2018 January 30th here. So now here you can see when we gave start dates and finish dates, the software automatically gave the duration as 6 days. So then we will see what we have to do next. So here, project calculates the duration as 6 days. So, okay, we already saw that. Note that this is 6 working days. Yes, Monday through Wednesday and Friday of the first week, and then Monday and Tuesday of the following week. So those are the 6 days. Project also draws the Gantt bar for the task to span these working days plus the non-working days. The Thursday, January 25th, morale event you set up in chapter 3, start a new plan plus the weekend between them. So here that means we can see, if we go to the chart portion view, we can see the Gantt bar also. And in the third chapter under practicals, we have given a non-working day on 25th of January. So so this Gantt bar has skipped that part also. So skipping that particular non-working day, they have taken these 6 days, Monday through Wednesday, Friday, and Monday and Tuesday. So then for task 6, launch public web portal for book. You don't know a duration or start or finish date yet, but you can still capture what you do know. So we will see what is meant by that. In the start field of task 6, enter about 2 weeks before launch complete. So for the task 6, we do not know any start date yet, but instead of the start date, we are going to enter this text, about 2 weeks before launch complete. So here, this is the task 6, and it's in the start field, we can type it. About 2 weeks before launch complete, and press enter. So I will enlarge it. So here you can see that one. And after that, then enter milestone task. The scenario, you just learned the date by which the new book launch planning activities need to be completed for the book launch to occur on time. So next we are going to give a specific event that is in order to indicate the completion of the planning stage. You want this date to have visibility in the plan. Continuing in the build task list plan, perform the following task. Insert a new milestone task name, planning complete, so that it will appear about task 3, public launch phase. So we are going to give this milestone activity, planning complete, to indicate the completion of the planning stage. So it should be above public launch phase. So this is the public launch phase. Above this one, we have to enter the milestone task. So we have to click on here, and then here we can select the milestone. And then under new milestone, we can type planning complete. Planning complete. And press enter. So here you can see in the chart portion view, the date of the planning complete is the 8th of January. So that is the start date of this project. So the due date is given as that, the 0 days. So because we did not indicate any relationship yet, that is why they have considered the date as the start date of the project. So we will see what we have to do next. So after that, create summary task to outline the plan. The scenario. The new book launch plan is developed enough now to be organized into two phases. So now we are going to divide our project plan into two stages. Continuing in the simple build task list plan, perform the following task. Take the public launch phase task, the summary task of task 5, distribute advance copies through 7 launch public web portal for book. So we will do that one. So here, from task 5 to task 7, distribute advance copies, coordinate magazine feature articles, and launch public web portal for book. So these three activities are going to be sub-activities of the public launch phase. So that means public launch phase is going to be the summary task. So that is a phase of the project. So we will make this public launch phase as the summary task. So in order to do that, we have to select these three activities together, and then we can click on this intent task button. So here the public launch phase is now a summary task. So the other three are its subtasks. So here the duration is given as 6 days. I told you that the duration of the summary task is going to be the sum of its sub-activities. So here this is 2 days, this is 6 days. So that means the duration of the summary activity should be 8 days. But currently they have given it as 6 days, because here this, even though we have given here as 2 days, we have not yet indicated the start date and finish date. So therefore that is why these 2 days are not considered for the summary task. The summary task considered only these 6 days. So, and the start date and finish date of the summary task are similar to the start date and finish day of this coordinate magazine feature articles activity. So that those values are considered under duration, start and finish fields. So that part is okay. And we will do the next part. And after that, Notice the scheduling effect of creating the summary task. Because task 6 had specific start and finish dates already, project set the start date of the summary task and its other subtasks with a duration to the same date, January 22. So we already saw that one. And second one, insert a new summary task named planning phase that will include task 1 through 3 so they become its subtask. So then we have to enter a new summary task. The name of the summary task is planning phase. So the subtasks are going to be task 1 through task 3. That means task 1, 2 and 3. So we will do that one. So here, these are these first three. Assign launch team members, design and order marketing materials, and planning complete. These three are going to be the sub-activities. So we are going to make these three activities the sub-activities of the planning phase summary task. So first we will select these three together. And then here we click on the summary button. So here we can get the new space, new summary task. So here we can type planning phase. Press enter. So here the duration is 1 day because the duration, we have only given the duration for the assigned launch team members activity yet. That is why the duration is also given as 1 day. And the start and finish dates are the start date of the project, because the sub activities do not have any start date or finish date yet. So the software automatically gave start dates and finish dates as the start date of the entire project. So next we will go to the next part. And then link task to create dependencies. Okay, now we are going to give the relationships. The scenario, the new book launch plan is coming together nicely. Tasks have been outlined under summary task and you are now ready to create task relationship. Continuing in the simple build task list plan, perform the following task. Enter a task ID in the predecessor field to link task 2 and 3 with a finish to start relationship. So now we are going to link task 2 and 3. We are going to form the relationship between this task 2 and 3, assign launch team members and design and order marketing materials. So we just have to type the value of the predecessor activity. So the predecessor activity is number 2, so we will type 2 here. So here in the chart portion view, you can see the forming of the relationship. And next, note that task 3 previously has no start date or finish date, but by making it a successor activity of task 2, you gave project enough information to give task 3 a start date, January 9th, the next working day following the end of task 2. So you can see it here. If we look at our project user interface, here for the task 3, previously we did not have any start date or finish date, but after forming the relationship, the project automatically gave start date and finish date for these two activities. Assigned launch team members also have start date and finish dates, and design and order marketing materials also have start date and finish because of the relationship. And next, you will link task 3 and 4 by using a different technique. So we will see what is the different technique. Make task 3 design and order marketing material a predecessor of task 4 by using the task information dialog box. So now we have to link the third task and fourth task by using the task information dialog box. So we will do that one. So this is the third one, design and order marketing material. And this is the fourth one, planning complete. So in order to do it with the task information dialog box, first of all, we have to double click on the fourth activity and go to the predecessor tab. And then here under the ID, we have to type the value of the predecessor activity. So the number of the predecessor activity is number 3. So we will type 3 here and press enter. So design and order marketing materials, and it is a finish to start relationship, and click OK. So again, project automatically type the number of the predecessor activity, and in the chart portion view, you can see the relationship. And now here see the date of the milestone task is now changed. It is 10th of January. Previously, it was 8th of January, and now the project changed it into 10th of January. Okay. And next one. So here, link all subtasks under public launch phase, task 6 through 8, all at once by using the link the selected task command. So now we have to create the relationship from task 6 to task 8. So in order to do that, we have to use this command, link the selected task. So these three, distribute advanced copies, coordinate magazine feature articles, and launch public web portal for book. So we have to select these three together. And then here you can see this button. In 2010 version, it says link task. But if you have 2013 or 2016 version, the name will appear as link the selected task. So click on that one. So then you can see the project created the relationship. So this is the predecessor task of task 7 is number 6, that is distribute advanced copies. The predecessor of 8.1 is the 7th task. And you can also see the project automatically gave the start dates and finish dates for these activities. So we will see the next part. And then, as you do so, keep an eye on task 8's text value of about 2 weeks in the start field. Notice that project replaced the text value in the start field of task 8 with a scheduled date and supplied the default 1-day duration. So that is here. Project did so. I will show it to you first. So here for the launch public web portal for book, in the previously it had some text about 2 weeks before launch complete, but now it is disappeared and the project gave it a new start date because of the relationship. So project did so because it required a date value for the task as soon as it was linked to another task. The question mark following the duration value indicates that this is an estimated duration. The question mark has no effect on the scheduling of the task. So that is also an important thing. So here I think I reminded that in the last class also. Here you can see some question marks. Here and here. So this question mark indicates it is an estimated duration, or else the question marks does not mean it is a questionable duration. That duration is estimated. That is why they give it a question mark. And after that, link task 1 planning phase to task 5 public launch phase by using your mouse in the chart portion of the Gantt chart view. So we will link these two tasks, task 1 and task 5, the two summary tasks. So here, this is the first task, planning phase, and this is the fifth task, public launch phase. So we have to link these two tasks by using the chart portion. So that means drag and drop method. So click on here and drag the mouse pointer here and drop it. Wait, I think something happened. We have to do it like this. Okay. So now the relationship is formed here. The project automatically gave number 1. If we need, we can just type 1 also. And then also the project will automatically form the relationship. It is not essential to do the drag and drop method. If we want to form the relationship, we can simply type the number of the predecessor task. Because the PDF book told me to do the drag and drop method, I performed it here. And then the next one is the Lucerne marketing team has reported that its estimate is that task 3 should have a 2-week duration. Change the duration of task 3 from the placeholder text check with marketing to 2 weeks. So we will do that one. So here. This one, design and order marketing materials. Currently, it has a text check with marketing team. So we have to substitute it with the 2 weeks duration. So I will type 2W. Okay, so now it has a duration, 2 weeks. So you can see the change in the chart portion view also. And then here you can see the finish date of the planning complete milestone task is underlined with the red line. Because now you can see this, there is a relationship here. This is the fourth activity, and the predecessor activity is task number 3. Design and order marketing material. So in order to start the planning complete phase, planning complete activity, we have to finish the design and order marketing materials first. So the finish date of design and order marketing materials is 22nd of January, and the start date of the planning complete is 10th of January. So that is not possible. This is an early date. So that is wrong. So we have to correct that one. So next we are going to correct that. So we will see it here. Notice that the new duration for task 3 caused the planning phase summary task duration to increase. But it did not affect the scheduling of tasks for milestone. Why not? Remember that this task is still manually scheduled. In the next step, you will force project to adjust the start and finish dates of this task to honor its predecessor task while leaving it as manually scheduled. So we will do that one. Adjust task for planning complete so it respects the predecessor link. So we will see how to do that one. Here, this is the planning complete. So we have to make sure that this planning complete activity respects the duration of its predecessor activity. So in order to do that, we have to click here. And in the task tab, you can see a button called Respect Links. So you have to click on that one. So when we click on that one, the project automatically changed the duration. Now the duration of planning complete is 23rd of January. So that is later than 22nd of January. So now this activity happens after finishing the third activity. So that is possible. So here you can see in the chart portion view also, they have given a new date. And then, project pre-schedules task 4 to start following the completion of its predecessor task 3. We already saw that one. You might have noticed that the start of the public launch phase summary task does not respect its link to its predecessor, the planning phase summary task. So you can see it here. I will show you. Here, the start date of the public launch phase, it is 22nd of January, but the finish date of planning phase is 23rd of January. So these are predecessor and successor activities. So the start date of public launch phase should be after the 23rd of January, but here it is not mentioned like that. Here public launch phase is going to start before finishing the planning phase. But even though it is like this, the project did not indicated any red line also. So we will see what is the reason for that one. So here, clicking the respect link button with the public launch phase summary task selected will not cause it to be rescheduled.
Recording stopped.
Sorry, I had electricity disconnection. I will start from there once again. So can you hear me? I don't know whether you can hear.
Yeah.
Okay, electricity disconnection happened. That is why it was blocked. So I will start once again. Wait a bit.
Gayan?
Okay. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Bye.
Okay, sir.
Recording in progress.
Okay, I had to wait until Thiru sir gave me the host. Without being the host, I cannot share anything now. So that is why I had to wait. So sorry for the interruption. So we stop from here. So this is where we were. So you might have not noticed that the start of the public launch phase SummaryTask does not respect its link to its predecessor, the planning phase SummaryTask. Clicking the respect link button with the public launch phase SummaryTask selected will not cause it to be rescheduled as it did for task 4. That is because the start and finish dates of the SummaryTask are driven by the earliest start and latest finish dates of the subtask, which in this case are still manually scheduled. So it is like this. Once again, can you tell whether you can hear me? I'm not sure. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So what I was explaining that here, for the start dates and finish date of each summary task, it is decided by the the start date of its first sub-activity and finish date of its last sub-activity. So here you can see 8th of January, that is the start date of the assigned launch team member. So that is the first sub-activity here. And finish date is 23rd of January, that is the finish date of the planning complete. So that is the last sub-activity of this planning phase. And here, under the public launch phase, start date is 22nd of January. So that is the start date of the first sub-activity, distribute advanced copies. And finish date is 2nd of February. So that is the finish date of the last sub-activity, launch public web portal for book. So the start dates and finish dates are decided by start date of the first sub-activity and finish date of last sub-activity. So that is why we cannot do anything even though the public launch phase start before finishing the planning phase. So that is the reason for that. These the start dates and finish dates of summary activities are depending on the start dates and finish dates of the sub-activities. So that is the reason. And the other reason is these sub-activities are still manually scheduled. If we convert this into auto-schedule, then the start date and finish date will respect the relationship. But as these are still manually scheduled, the start date and finish date of summary activities depend on the start date and finish date of sub-activities. So then we will see the next part. Switch task scheduling from manual to automatic. So now we are going to convert those manually scheduled activities into automatically scheduled activities. And then there will be the respectfulness between the relationships. The scenario, the new book launch plan has been reviewed by the resources who will carry out the work and by other project stakeholders. Although you expect the plan to change somewhat as you learn more about the book launch, you now have enough confidence in the plan overall to switch from manual to automatic task scheduling. So continuing in the simple build task list plan, perform the following tasks. So now we are going to change our plan from manual to automatic. Switch tasks 2 through 4 to be automatically scheduled by using the auto schedule command on the task tab. So we will do that one. So here, so task 2 through 4, 2, 3 and 4. These three we can convert into auto schedule. So we can click auto schedule here. So now these three are converted into automatically scheduled task. And then here, project changes the task mode icon and formatting of the gun bars to indicate that they are now automatically scheduled. So we already saw that one. Then use the task mode field of task 6 to change it to be automatically scheduled. So we will do that one. So this is the sixth task. So in the task mode, we have to change it into auto schedule like this. And then you can see what happens. Now, because this is auto schedule, the start date of the summary activity change into 23rd of January. And you can see, because now these are also auto scheduled, the finish date of the planning phase is 22nd of January. And the start date of public launch phase is 23rd of January. So these are now respectful for the links. And with that, you can see there is a red underline for the finish date of the coordinate magazine feature articles, because the finish date of the distribute advanced copies is 24th of January, and the start date of the next activity also 24th of January, and that is also impossible. So that is why there is a red line here. So we will see what we can do about that. So here, this time task 6 was rescheduled to start later. Why did this happen? Recall the dependency between the two summary tasks. The dependency said, in effect, that the public launch phase should start when the planning phase was finished. So that we already know. However, because task 6 and other subtasks of the public launch phase were manually scheduled, project did not reschedule the subtask to account for this dependency. So even though task 6 is now automatically scheduled, but other remaining task 7 and task 8 are still manually scheduled. As soon as you set task 6 to automatic scheduling, project also adjusted the start date of its summary. So we also saw that one. The remaining subtasks 7 and 8 are still manually scheduled, so project did not pre-schedule them. So switch task 7 and 8 to be automatically scheduled by using any method you prefer. So now we will convert 7th task and 8th task into automatic scheduling. So here, task 7 and 8. So I will select both of task 7 and 8, and then I will click on auto schedule. So both of these are auto scheduled, and now you can see the red line is disappeared because the software automatically gave coordinate magazine feature articles a new start date, 26th of January. So that is after 24th of January. And then these are launch public web portal for book. The start date is 5th of February. So it is after finishing the 7th activity. And after that, project reschedules the remaining tasks. So we saw that one. This extends the duration of the public launch phase and of the overall project. So now the finish date of the public launch phase is renewed, and the entire duration of the project is also renewed because now it has a latest finish date. And then Right now, this plan is set to treat any new task you might enter as manually scheduled. You could leave this setting as is and then switch specific tasks to be automatically scheduled. However, this plan is developed enough now to switch to automatic scheduling. You can later set some specific tasks to manually scheduled as needed. So now all the new tasks are manually scheduled. If we type any new activity, that will be considered as a manually scheduled task. So next we have to do is switch the plan to make all new tasks automatically scheduled. So now we are going to change that one. So here, now in the new task, we can change it as auto-scheduled. So we can click on auto-scheduled. Now if we type any new activity, it will be considered as an auto-scheduled activity. And after that, next thing is enter a new task name, launch social media programs for book below task 8. So we will enter this new activity, launch social media programs for book. So it should be below task 8. Launch social media programs for book. So, and press enter. So now you can see it is auto scheduled because we gave new task to be auto scheduled. So the software automatically gave it a 1 day duration, and the duration of the activities, the start date and finish date are 23rd of January. That is the start date of the public launch phase. So this task is considered as a sub activity of public launch phase summary task. That is why the software gave the due start date and finish dates as the 23rd of January. So here you can see it in the chart portion view also. And then project adds the new task to the plan. By default, it is not linked to any other task, is given a 1 day duration, and is scheduled to start at its summary task start date. So we already saw that one. And then link task 8 and 9. So we will do that one. We can link these two tasks, 8 and 9. So I will type 8 here because it is the predecessor. So now the start dates and finish dates are changed. The start date is 6th of February and finish date also 6th of February because it has a 1 day duration. So you can see that what happened in the chart portion view also. So here you can see that one. And then so after that we have to do this one. Project link to task. Notice that the duration of the public launch phase summary task was updated automatically from 9 to 10 days. So you can see it here. So here the duration of public launch phase is 9 days. Before it was now 10 days, before it was 9 days and now 10 days. And then check a plan's duration and finish date. The scenario, your plan for the new book launch is helping the team get organized for the upcoming work. You are free frequently asked to provide the currently scheduled duration and finish date for the book launch. Continuing in the simple build task list plan, perform the following task. So now we are going to see the start date and finish date of this overall project. In the timeline view, note the plan's current start and finish dates. So we will see it. So this is the timeline view. I will enlarge this one. So here you can see start date as the 8th of January and here finish date. Finish date is this one. This 6th of February. So this is the timeline view. You can see it here. And then find the plan's finish date in the project information dialog box. Next, look at the duration information in more detail in the project statistics dialog box. So we will do those two activities. So here, first we will see the finish date of the project in the project information dialog box. So you have to click on project tab and go to the project information button. And then you can get this dialog box, project information for simple build task list. And here you can see the finish date, 6th of February 2018. And then you can see the same details in the project statistics dialog box. So click on the statistics button. And then you can get this dialog box called project statistics for simple build task list. And here you can see the start date of the project, 8th of January, finish date as 6th of February. And also you can see total duration, that is 21 days. And then remaining duration is also 21 days, because even though we have prepared the project plan, we have not yet started working on our project. So the work is also 0 hours, because we have not done any work practically. And cost is also $0 because we have not incurred any cost yet. And percent complete, duration is 0%. Work also 0% because we have not done anything practically yet. And then we can close it. And after that, display the project summary task in the Gantt chart view. So we will display the project summary task. So to display the project summary task, you have to go to the task tab. Click on the task tab and format tab. Click the format tab and then go to this checkbox, project summary task. When you click it, so you can see this is the name of the project, Simple Plan. So if you put your cursor to the note icon, you can see that text, new children's book for spring release. So we type this statement under the comments. So you can see it here. File, project information, advanced properties. So under the comments, we have typed new children's book for spring release. So that is indicated there. So that is indicated here. And then, and also you can see the total duration as 21 days. The start date of the project is 8th of January and finish date is 6th of February. And after that, document task information. So we will do that one. You have some details about a few weeks in the new book launch plan that you would like to record in the plan. This will help you later by keeping such details right in the plan. And it will also be valuable for any other project, stakeholders who might work with the plan in the future. Continuing in the simple build task list plan, perform the following task. So now we are going to enter some notes here. So first one is, at the note, get recipient list from the publicist to task 6, distribute advanced copies. So we will do that one next. To task 6, we have to give this note, get recipient list from the publicist. So here, so this is the task 6. So to this task, we have to enter that note. So double click on that and get the task information dialog box. And under notes, you can type, get the recipient list from the publicist, and you can press OK. And then here you can see the note icon, get the recipient list from the publicist. And after that, what we have to do is, so point to the note icon for task 6. The note appears in a screen tip, so we already saw that one. I'm not going to do it again. And point to the note icon for task 0. So that is the project summary task. So I will not explain that one again because you already explained that one. So I will go to the fourth step. At the hyperlink test, add to Spring Catalog here with an address of http www.lucernepublishing.com to task 8, launch public web portal for book. So for the task 8, I have to enter this hyperlink and its text should be add to Spring Catalog here. So we will do that one. So here, this is the task 8. So right click on that one and click hyperlink and then get this dialog box, insert hyperlink. So here the text should be add to Spring Catalog here. And give me 1 minute. I have to do something. Okay. So then address should be http://www.lucernepublishing. This one, it is already given for us. lucernepublishing.com. And we can press OK. So now here, you can see the hyperlink and the text is add to Spring Catalog here. And next thing we will do. So the next one is, a hyperlink icon appear in the indicators column. Point to the icon, display the descriptive text you entered earlier. So we have already done that one. And next. Okay, that is all in this chapter. So then I will stop today's session from here. So do you have any question from today's part? So if you can have any question, you can type it in your chat box or you can unmute your mic and ask it. Okay, you don't have any question, then I will stop today's session from here. So because of the electricity disruption, today you will have 2 videos, first video and the second video. Because there will be 2 recordings. So I will send you both recordings to Thiru sir and he will upload it into your LMS. So we will meet on, with the 5th chapter in the next week, Wednesday. And also I request you to read the 5th chapter, this one, before coming to the next class, read this one. set up resources, read these things and try to understand. Then if you read this, you can better understand the things I teach you here. So in order to do this fifth chapter also, I'm going to use my building construction project same example. So I'm going to continue by setting up resources. I will do it in our next class. So we will meet on next Wednesday. So until then, take care, stay safe, and try to avoid COVID-19 situation as much as possible. So thank you. You can leave now.